This is O2 Inside Line, This Rose, Episode 3.
We got the game.
This won't work now. Have you given me a dodgy one?
Yeah.
Yes.
This week is the start of week 4 in terms of our preparations for the World Cup. The big difference was we had 14 new players join us. They predominantly are players from the Premiership final, so the Sale and Saracens players. We've got some great work done in the first 3 weeks, great intensity and great workload that we've increased week by week. I suppose some of the key aspects of this week's training has got to be integrating those incoming players, make sure they get up to speed with the learnings that we've achieved in those first 3 weeks, as well as the new players coming in and adding their own intensity to training. The back row is a particular area of interest to myself, of course. We've got 9 back row forwards in this week. A good mixture of those that have got plenty of experience, but a couple of players that are uncapped and untested at international level, but certainly adding to the environment with their energy and enthusiasm to want to learn. Whilst the players do want to be competitive, they are ultimately pushing for places. It's more important that what we're seeing is those players coming together, supporting one another, pushing one another, but in the right way.
Well done, lads. Well done. We've honestly come in today and thought that's been a massive step forward over these last 3 weeks. Massive step forward. And we're just starting. So massive well done, boys. I'm looking forward to ripping in for the rest of it.
Good and back.
Apparently
my invite to his wedding didn't come in the post.
Royal Mail is shocking at the moment.
Wow, I think the last time we were sat like this was in Tokyo.
No way.
Hey, look at that. was that good enough?
Cut.
Yeah.
Curry and Underhill.
I think that's good.
Sam and Tom, preferably.
Sam, Tom. There we go. That's the sync, isn't it?
A lot's happened in our lives. Sam's got married, I've got a dog.
You've got a girlfriend?
I've got a girlfriend.
Is that official?
Yeah. And Sam didn't invite me to his wedding because apparently we've never seen each other outside of camp.
You're never in Bath, I'm never in Manchester. So it's nice that we keep this sort of semi-professional relationship, and I wouldn't want to spoil that by inviting you to my wedding.
It's like what everyone says, it's good in small doses.
Yeah, distance makes the heart grow fonder, doesn't it? For sure. We don't actually spend that much time together outside of stuff like this. It's a bit of an illusion.
Strictly cameras.
It's like, you know, like celebrity couples, like Kim and Kanye when they were together.
They don't really spend any time together. Don't start throwing quotes.
I just mean it's like, this is an image thing. It's like a brand thing. It's not really a, it's not really a friendship. You kindly gave one of the lads your full England kit for my stag do, with Curry 7 on the back.
We had to go out of the way to put the names on.
Yeah, thanks for that. That was really kind. I'd like to be invited to your wedding. I don't have to come, but an invite would be
so
nice.
So you want an
invite? No, like if you don't want me there, it'd be nice to get the invite, even if it's like an evening guest. The last 3 weeks, obviously, you've not been in, but it's been good. Lads have got through some good sort of content and as a team really pushed on, and it's definitely got more intense this week, I'd say, with the inclusion of you boys.
So we got sent our programmes probably like 3 or 4 days into our off-season. We kind of got a little insight into kind of what the lads would be doing. You know, coming back into camp and, you know, being able to do the session with the lads and the team stuff and getting involved, it's a lot more fun, I'd say. So it's been good to get back in and cracking.
Oh, you said the lads like 5 times as well.
I only deal in
so cliche. It's fairly honest, hard work. The coaches are all pretty clear on what they want and expect from the lads, and it's kind of on us to deliver from a work point of view. We just have to do our thing and learn the lessons that they're trying to teach us.
The lads.
I wasn't involved in the Six Nations, so this is my first taste of the new sort of setup. And yeah, there's a lot of energy, enthusiasm, nice balance between the coaches, guys that I've not worked with before. Yeah, it's just generally a very respectful, sort of energetic and hard-working environment.
I think coming in, especially this week, and being, you know, having to catch up with kind of the knowledge stuff and obviously the physical side of it as well. Everyone's been very clear, coaches and players, like trying to get you up in terms of what they expect from you as an individual, but also what we want from a team. I think that's really important, especially going to quite a serious and not frantic but busy schedule now. I think that's really important once the games start coming.
So distracting. It's so. Can we pan? You pan around to Joe Marler. Are you getting a bit of content for yourself here? Have you got? Have you got a dog filter on? Haven't you? You got a dog filter on, haven't you? Yeah, good. Oh. Yeah, well done. Oh.
It feels very lined up. It's less organic, a bit more organic.
It's weird seeing your brother whilst you're doing bits and bobs on the pitch or in meetings. I'm always keeping half an eye out to see if he's there and not missing something. I think that's natural, but I know the big fella will be all right either way.
My point of view, obviously, with everything that happened this season with Wasps, like, it wasn't something I didn't know if they would get another chance to be in the same sort of environment together. So that's obviously something that means a lot. It means a lot to us. We've always enjoyed that the last 6-7 years we've had at Wasps together. So the opportunity to do that again is pretty cool. We got the taxi in together, and I've not seen him since. He doesn't spend much time with me, so no, it's been nice. He's helped me out and like a lot of stuff prepping going into it as well, like learning roles and having someone to bounce off and talk to is. Yeah, makes it a lot easier.
Our perspective, it was probably a little bit surreal, both meeting at mum and dad's to get a taxi here together was pretty cool. And even though it was meant to be just for me, but I saved the day because he had a punch and tire. So it's always
so panic stations, straight away day come, one, come down he's under the wing. Yeah.
This is the first World Cup preparation I've been involved in. I think it definitely feels like a level up. Obviously, there was a change of coaches in the four Six Nations, and I loved the Six Nations campaign and being part of that group, and really felt like I took a step forward. And now it's a very competitive group in every position, and I think for me and Tom as well, we know how good the back row is, and we want to try and help each other along that way, because it'll be a dream to both be part of that World Cup group. Looking back to sort of October, where we were sitting in some pretty painful meetings as a group at WAS, getting told that we no longer had jobs and the group was going to be completely split up and WAS sort of is no more. Then at the end of the autumn series, jetting straight out to Toulouse and cracking on with the season there. Then the Six Nations, which was great to be part of. And then the final run-in with Toulouse has been pretty crazy, playing in really big games that I never would have dreamt of being part of, and then going sort of all the way a couple of weeks ago and winning the top 14 was just an incredible feeling. And I was sort of in disbelief after that final whistle, to be honest with you, and looking up and like Tom was in the stands and all my family. And yeah, it was pretty emotional. having everyone there, and now feel fortunate enough, given how competitive the back row is, to have the opportunity to come into camp and be alongside Tom and try and achieve getting into this World Cup squad, and then if part of it, going on to try and win and compete in that World Cup. Oh, I couldn't have got through it without Tom and the rest of my family. So, yeah, it's good having that sort of support network around you for sure.
If you'd said to me 8 months ago that you were going to move to France, play for 8 months, and then end up in a World Cup preparation squad at the end of the season, yeah, it's pretty cool the way it's all worked out. First time in, people getting their arm around me, sort of helping me out, make sure I know what's going on. You can tell people have been together the last 3 weeks, so that's spent a lot of time together as a group in the team area, even when no meetings in rugby. You're getting playing pool, playing darts and just chatting.
So tonight we've got a little bit of a cricket social event, which would be good fun. I feel like I'm underrated with my cricket skills. I've gone under the radar so far, so I'm hoping to surprise a few people. Pretty sure Tom will deliver what's expected of him, which is probably not much in the cricket department.
So we've been put into teams drawn out of a hat, but I'm pretty sure it's fixed because all the great cricketers are in one group. And then I'm lumped in with lower front five forwards, so I'm going to be hiding in the field somewhere. Try to keep my head down.
Ball, 10 balls each. Minimum. It is, you have to reverse the batting order for the second game. So, a bit tactics easy there, so everyone gets to go, John. If you're at number 11, you'll be opening 10. You'll be opening the batting next time, John. Okay.
So, 10 balls each at the bat.
10 balls. You probably won't bowl, John. I'll be honest.
Number 5. Umpires, mate, match officials.
Just officiating, that's all.
Tom, we've got Tom here, we've got Tom.
Go, Tom!
Yes!
Tried to bank.
He was out, mate! He was out!
You threw it over there!
I mean, it was nearly cheated out of us. I think I would have gone to the authorities if we lost that.
Yeah,
one.
That would be it.
But they like to come, mate.
A little bit worried because we have actually conceded quite a lot. Owen and Mark has put on a bit of a spell. Jack Willis is surprisingly quite good at bowling, given that he's never played cricket before. Ben Earl, who we were told could have played professional cricket given the game he played last Monday in a charity game, went for about 30 and 5 balls. So that's let us down a little bit, but you know, he's a good cricketer, he'll make it up. Oh, I'm in the game here.
We've just posted 79 and we're just trying to contain the boys. Set a very negative field here, everyone's on the boundary.
Oh!
Bevan's just hit Fred for 2 sixes in a row. So it's not looking good.
Six to draw.
Leslie, say no more.
Come on, Fred.
No ball!
I want the six!
Yes! 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 Yes